I'm Tiffany Benham.
I'm Tony Benham.
And this is Wesley Cash Benham. When he was 9 months old, he started having febrile seizures.
They sent us down here is when they'd done the blood work and his CK levels were skyrocket.
Dr. Thomas gave me two options of what it could be, and that was a metabolic disorder or muscular dystrophy. He said, and if we can, we're going to pinpoint it down, which he did. We came in, I think it was like maybe a month later, and that's when he broke the news to me. Wesley had been diagnosed with Duchenne's muscular dystrophy.
Duchenne muscular dystrophy, it's a rare muscular dystrophy. It's a progressive disease that can affect the boys. They usually present to us around the age of, 4 to 5 years with muscle weakness. It's usually caused by a genetic change in a gene called DMD gene. And these boys actually lack the protein called dystrophin protein. Elevidys is a gene transfer treatment that was recently approved by the FDA for treatment of boys with Duchenne muscular dystrophy who are age 4 and 5 years old. It's actually giving them a miniature version or a small version of this dystrophin protein that's already missing.
Honestly, I decided that Elevidys would be good, and only because I spoke with his doctor, Dr. Panda. I think that he's an amazing doctor. When he said, well, the medicine is good to go, it's approved for 4 and 5 year olds, I said, what do you think? He was like, well, I think it's gonna be great. I was like, no, you don't tell me as a doctor. I want you to tell me as a parent, what do you think about this medicine? He said, well, I'm the doctor that worked on this medicine, and I approve of it 100%.
Wesley was the first boy in the state of Arkansas to receive this Elevidys treatment after FDA approval. It's a one-time intravenous infusion. After the infusion, these boys need close follow-ups. We see them at least once a week to get some blood work, and sometimes we also see them in the clinic to make sure they're doing okay.
As a mother, there is no better feeling in the world than to have a place to go that you feel safe and you can trust the people around you to help you with your child. But to know that there's nothing that even the smartest people I know can do for my son other than try to extend his life rather than save it, I'm just as happy with that.
As far as Wesley's future care, I think we would continue to follow him in our multidisciplinary clinic. It's kind of too soon to say how he's going to respond, but we would expect that this treatment would delay the disease progression and improve his lifespan and his quality of life.